administration. The Bible said in Exodus chapter 3, he said, Amos is kind of like a Jethro, his father in law, the priest of Midian. And he led the flock to the black side of the desert, and came to the mountain of God, even to the glory. And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a flame of fire. The angel of the Lord shall appear to you tonight. Somebody did not know the meaning. The angel of the Lord appeared unto me in a flame of fire out of the midst of the bush. And he looked, and behold, the bush burned with fire, and the bush was not consumed. They are supposed to be living nations. But God appeared to me in one particular day like this. And this evening, I want you to reach up to me. And say, if it is only one person, this day and level that you want to appear to, let it be me. Father, let it be me. Let it be me. If it is only one singular person that you want to appear to, that you want to play this evening, let it be me. I don't want to come here today. Father, as you appear, as your angel appear to Moses, appear to me tonight, appear to me and show me this. Let your power look at me. Let this be you for me today. Let this be you for me. This be you for me and my family. Mama, if it is one singular person that you are prepared to talk tonight, let it be me. I'm blessing of me. I'm blessing of God. I'm blessing. I'm blessing of me. We give you glory from the Lord to this moment. You have been our strength. You have been there with us. Father, we really appreciate it. We are not taking it for granted to talk to your table here in heaven. We say thank you for this great privilege. We now are sorted in the name of Jesus. Mighty God, we pray. You that located Moses, please locate us tonight by your mercy. Attend to us by your mercy.
Away, but God in his divine arrangement again, says, I am the God. I can still work it out for this boy to fulfill his destiny. We are talking about favor. God favored him again. And that was the reason in Exodus chapter 3. God now called him. Said, no, come and fulfill your destiny. God has called you today. And you are acting to his voice. The favor that you are going to receive today will make you to live a fulfilled life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Let me tell you, anybody that is trying to help God will ruin his or her destiny. I have an example of it in the Bible. Rachel thought, for the fact that God said, you have a two nations in your womb. The older will serve the younger one. It's a secret. How God will work it out, he knows. God was not expecting Rachel to help him. And that was the reason why I do want parents. Please, if God has given you the grace to have insight into the future of your child or any of your children, do not help God. You cannot help God. It can only lead to your destruction. Hello? And may I tell you, Rachel thought, I want to help God. The father that said, Esau, come unto me, prepare a meal for me, because I'm old, let me bless you before I depart from this world. Rachel helped herself, thinking that he wants to help God. To cut the long story short, through a corny way, Jacob received the blessing. Even though that has been the plan of God. By the time Jacob went and came back, the man that said, I am old, was still alive. The one that said, let me help God for the fulfillment of his plan in the life of Jacob, she was no more. Please, parents, stop helping God. You can't even help God. By the time you are applying human knowledge, you are destroying your destiny. The favor that Moses received, may we receive that favor today in Jesus' name. Amen. Even the favor that better that of Moses, may we receive it today in the name of Jesus. Amen. Do you know the reason why I tell you the one that better than that of Moses? Moses received the second chance, but did not get to the promised land. Why? Because he was in the place of authority where God placed him. He thought that he was the one doing the war. He thought that, yes, through my power. Okay, do this, people. Come and drink water. You said you don't have water. And you are not going to live in it. People that God called my people. And that's the main reason why we even need the ministers of God. We need to be very careful. Hello? We need to be very careful. Favor connotes an act of kindness beyond what is due or usual. It connotes the kind of kindness that you receive from God, which is beyond what you deem for. I've said it times without number. I'm not worthy to hold the mic preach the gospel. It is the favor that I receive. I was once a persecutor of the brethren. I was one of the people that normally put cry, tears in the heart, in the eyes of the believers whenever they come to church like this. When people are shouting happy new year, I will want to make them to weep and shed tears because I already have my package where I begin to blow into them. And because of the irreverential again, a lot of things will, I'm not worthy, only a venerable leader. And that's the very thing. There's some people when they see me even now that I'm carrying the Bible, they run away. But then, boy, again, it is the favor of God. It is the favor of God. I am not worthy. Things work out for him. When you are favored, things begin to work out for you. Show me anyone that is mightily blessed in the Bible or in this present world, and I will tell you the person is highly favored. In favor doesn't mean the kind, how educated you are. No. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
What is the degree that Bill Gates has? What is the degree that this our man in Nigeria, that go to his hand? What degree? By favor located there. May the favor open your eyes.
Amen.
For you to see and get to the right place in the name of Jesus. It doesn't matter the kind of background that you came from. Such a person becomes a preferred person above all his peers, above every other person around him. In the book of 1 Samuel chapter 16, right from verse 3, you will discover that God sends a servant to the house of Jesse. May I quickly tell us that Jesse is not the only family in that land. But why is it that God decided that it is Jesse? Jesse, before this time, nobody knows him. People might have written you off because you don't have money in your pocket. People might have written you off, leaving you off because you are not even living in a good house. Because you don't have a car. Because you are here tonight and you want to partake in the Holy Communion of favor. That favor will send you your house. And you will be preferred in the name of Jesus. Look at it. When God sent the servant to the family of Jesse, is among the people in the land, Jesse's family were preferred. That's one thing. Another thing is that when God has said, it is not everyone in the house of Jesse, there's one particular person. All the senior ones begin. And that is to say, favor has nothing to do with where you were born or who gave back to you. 37. I'm talking about the story of Joseph. Joseph was not the firstborn, neither the secondborn, but because of the fact that he was highly favored. He was highly favored. He was picked. And God said, okay, there will be fulfillment of the promises that I made with Abraham many years ago. In life, he was highly favored. The meal that God has prepared for us today will make you and I to be highly favored. one poor brother, talking about Joseph, they ate him, they sold him out. They said, now let's see how a dream will come to pass. It doesn't matter where you have lived before. It doesn't matter where you are living now. Why? Because the Bible says that even when Joseph was in the prison, he was favored. Anywhere you get to, you will be highly favored. In the name of Jesus Christ, in this strange land where he knew nobody, God made everything to work for him. I decree to your life today, in the name that is above every other name, after partaking in today's holy communion of favor, oh, in any way you step to shall be delivered to you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Those people that have run in town, they run in town, they gave the bow for him. As many that have said to themselves, that your guest is a forgotten issue, they will come back to you and they will bow for you. In them yesterday, today, and forevermore. The Bible says, he can do all things. It says, all things work together for good. All things. Why? Nobody get to the promised land without bitterness experience. What you are passing through today is to make your story to be completed. So that when you are sharing your testimony, people will be amazed and they will conclude that yes, it is only God that can do this. The Bible says, only to me, only one show love for one, we read this for the communion. Because you will be prepared, because you will be highly favored, your world will be matter. Esther was a slave. Nobody could ever think that Esther can become a queen. Even when Mordecai said, okay, oh yeah, as for me, you know, it take a long for. I know Esther will not even be opportune to have your it. Because of the fact that it has been ordained by God. Esther put on that little rattle that she had, and the king looked at her, said, this is the one I prepare. And among the people that will be contending with you, in the name that is above every other name, you will be single. In the name of Jesus, you are leaving that position to the place of authority. Thank you.